Hey everybody, Automator MC here, and another episode of Valheim. I think I got as far as I can go for now. I didn't kill the last two bosses, but I don't think there's a ton of content wrapped around them yet. Game is early access, but I don't think I can do a full series on this right now. I'll show you what I got right now, and I'll come back maybe 6 months or so. And we'll see how much they've added. Right now, it's still very early. I thought it was huge. Here is the map. I've revealed all you can see here is that's it. And I've already seen the same biomes already a few times each with repeating everything. So I'm not in any way hacking on it. I think this game is still phenomenal. It's just that they need to finish some stuff up, take a little time, and I'm all good with that. Yeah, I never tried panning the map around like that before. Kind of cool. Yeah, I'm guessing, or I'm hoping, that they just add a whole bunch of stuff to this, because the potential is mind-blowing. So what I got so far, let's start running around. Oh, I built a pig farm. I tore it down because it wasn't working very well. And they don't really have any automation stuff like Minecraft, so there's not a lot you can do with farms that are going to be really cool. So what I found is the best thing to do is just put them in here. Of course, I have to harvest my crops before I start killing these guys, because I'll kill my crops at the same time. I just take some turnips and I throw a few over here, and around in the middle. And I think they'll just keep breeding and get pretty good numbers in here. Still, probably the better way right now is just to run through the mountain biome and kill foxes. Although in the patch notes this morning, they reduced their spawn rates. So who knows? And this game might change so dramatically that all that will change. But right now, if you're going to raise boars, I'm thinking this is the way. In reality, the best way that I've gotten to meet is when I revealed the map. When I was running around, every time I run into boars, I kill them. And that seemed to be about the best, fastest way to get meat. So I don't have any meat products going on right now. Okay, chests are in the floor. That's a big improvement. I started doing that in Minecraft a long time ago. And I just carried over the same technique here. I got signs. They're kind of hard to read. But this is my cash box. I went and sold all I had for money. And I bought a bunch of stuff that's not used in the game. I don't even know where I put it. Oh, it'd be in here. It's not. I don't know where I put it. That flesh, it's like a crafting material. I don't know where I put it. It doesn't really matter anyway. It does now. It's driving me nuts. Anyway. So this is a stew and soup box. When I go into battle, I don't usually use these fish eggs. Actually, I usually have it like this. So if I'm working around the town, I don't need anything. If I'm getting somewhat risky, I'll just pop these two. But if I'm going into battle, I'll hit the soup, carrot soup, this, and I just don't have any turnip soup going on right now. I mean, I could make some. I got meat, and I could make sausages and stuff. But I don't need to do any of this stuff right now, so I'm not worrying about it really bad. Okay, bed is right here. I had to move it, and it's kind of a weird spot, but you gotta have it centrally located to get your highest. It's gotta be where your highest comfort level is to get your biggest buff, rested buff. So, gotta be close enough to the fire, gotta be close enough to, items that raise your comfort level, that kind of stuff. I have more than what I need. I was just experimenting around trying to do some cool stuff. These things I don't care for too much. They're always empty. They always run out. That one just plain doesn't work because it's too close to the ceiling. And this is just out of fuel, so... Oh, no! Whoops! Yeah, using the wrong thing for the job there. Okay. I put this lower because I thought it looked cool, or I'm going to raise it back up because, as you can see, it gets in my camera sometimes. So, if I... you know, go to it. I'll raise that up. Venters up here, easy access. Again, if I need the room and it add a lot more stuff, I can still keep everything in here. All I need to do is see the bottom of them. And just, or I could also put them in the floor, like the chests, and just look down and click on it. But the item drops are going to be below them. So, yeah, so they got to be above you. Yeah, looks out pretty well. I really like my porch I made. Taking a good look around, and it's got a nice little chimney there for the smoke. And if you look over here, you can see, if I turn the camera there, you can see I got a trencher on most of the base. I haven't had any damage. I killed the swamp boss, so I get skeleton raids now. The only time I had any kind of problem was with when a troll, from a troll raid, a troll spawned right in the center of my garden. But now I have this fence in here, I have a crafting table over there, and I have a door. So I think that will tell the game that this is, you know, my house. So I left out a step here and dug a little hole that prevents mobs from getting in. Here's where my pig farm was. So no mobs can get in here. They don't know how to navigate that, but I can very easily. So I usually leave this door open. The bars won't be able to get out or anything. Just closing it for no reason whatsoever right now. This one I always leave open. You probably saw in the first video that this doesn't go all the way down to the ground. And that's for a very good reason, because no mobs can get in. All I have to do is jump. So, the beehives. So far, this is kind of like my best. I have a little pathway and I just run along and... Well, I got honey and I'm good. Oh, I'm trying to... I have my mouse... My mouse program has to be on for me to use my side key. And I have E assigned to it. That's why I wasn't harvesting them. Because that program is off. Yeah. So that works out good. Because the steps that I exit on takes care of all the honey that falls out this side. And I obviously pick up any that falls out that side. So far, so good. I could always extend it longer. I only have one beehive there. That won't work, obviously, but I could extend this road out a ways. They aggro mobs really bad, so that's why I have them in base and protected. Okay. I think that about covers what I've done here. Oh, as far as gear, big change. I'm still using the shield. Jury's out on that, but I'm definitely going full troll. Full troll, best armor in the game. I got the heavier stuff, but it's sitting in a chest because, wow. They need to do a little bit of balancing with that. It's somebody gave me this knife, by the way. I haven't got that far. I haven't used it. I don't know why it's in the chest. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to take that right now and throw it in the garbage pile. By the way. Yeah, I don't want to see anything I haven't experienced already. So, yeah, I got this. This is my highest tier of armor so far. And it's sitting in this chest, tucked away, because it makes you move so slow, you're going to die. And you're going to be out of stamina, because you're running to get to mobs and stuff. And, oh, yeah, they got to do some serious balancing there. Troll is absolutely the best way to go, because you can run away. You know, if you're in a tight spot. Best armor in the world is running away. And if you're running through the woods, you're trying to get to someplace fast because you don't like going slow, like me, you won't be out of stamina. With the other stuff, you're going to be moving like this fast, and your stamina is going to be just dropping. No fun. So the higher tier armor is actually worse. Stay alive way better. And I can take just as much of a hit with troll armor as I can with the other stuff. Yeah. I mean, it's all... All your health is in your food, is in what you eat. So if I, you know, just keep eating good stuff, I don't have the best stuff. So this is kind of a little bit lower level from where I should be. That's what your, you know, your health. That's it. Speed is way better than armor. Okay. I could just sit here and, you know, wait for an attack to come. I probably, if they add like contact quick here, and I do it again, I'll have to go all the way around with the moat, because the skeletons do come and beat on my walls. They don't hurt it, but, you know, eventually I'll have to think about going there to repair them. And with the trench, I won't. The only thing is if people throw stuff at them, and I haven't really experienced that yet. So, my unconnected portal is unconnected right now, so I don't have much adventuring going on. I'm going to take you out and show you... Well, let me take a little nap here. And I'll go show you my plains. Little fort I built in the plains. Seems to work pretty well. I actually caught a shaman. Don't know what the benefit of that is or not. Comfort level 17. Good. I haven't tested it yet, so that is a good sign. And looks like it quit raining. Alright, let's go to the plains. I was doing building, wasn't I? Copper. I don't know how I got that. Oh yeah. Wall hooks and stuff, placing items. So, I am in the plains, but I haven't beat the mountain boss yet, so I have a flax and a barley, but there's nothing I can do with it. I don't know what it's for or anything. So here's my little fort, little perimeter walk around. Always got to pop my head up. Very first thing, look for those damn bugs, because they hurt no matter what you're wearing for armor. And looks like we're okay. Now I was hoping the loxes would respawn in this area. Hopefully it's not a one-time spawn. There's a deer over there, way over there. Yeah, I was really hoping they'd come back. Down here, when I was building this trench, there was a shaman who came in the trench. So what I did was put stone walls around him, and he's in there. I don't know why, but okay, loxes are so dumb. If you're out in the field fighting them, you just jump on a rock, and they won't be able to see you. And this castle, I put these stairs here, so I just walk on these stairs, and then Lox will see me. He'll come towards me, and then if he gets too close, I'll just get back on the wall. He won't see me, and then he'll walk away, and I'll just go back and forth and fire arrows. I don't know how many, like maybe 10, 15 of those to kill him. So this is my little plains thing. Humble. It started out over here in this thing that they made, but wow, they can do a lot of damage. There must be a lot less hit points on their structures than our stone walls, because they just beat the heck out of this. So also the thing is, I built this plane on the plains biome, and is it meadows? I don't even know what the first biome is called. It is, oh, this is Black Forest. Okay, I should have looked at the trees. So anyway, the mobs come out at night and they fight with my plains mobs, which might not be here anymore. They don't respawn. So what I'll probably do is just pop side off of that, let the shaman escape, and he'll walk around in this trench. And then if there's ever a reason to farm the drops, I got so many of their parts already, I'll never spend them. So yeah, I'll remove that wall. Just let the shaman walk around here. He won't be able to get out. I don't think he'll bother me much. So anyway, that's what I got going on here. And the rest of the map, I think, is... Oh yeah, they changed the... what was that guy? The swamp boss. So I just fought him again, and wow, that was a really easy fight. But that, maybe it's best just to look on the map. Elder, right here. Yeah, that was the last thing I did. I got to him. Is this gonna help? I had a dungeon, this one I completed it, nearby, so I could have done the walk on the door thing, but I never really had to, because there was a tree root, and when he came close to me, I just got behind the tree root, and he couldn't see me anymore, so he turned around and went away, and super easy fight. Yeah, that was incredibly easy. First time I fought him, it seemed like I was just getting totally punished. Why does it say unconnected? Oh, I renamed that. Yeah, after I did that, because I was still using unconnected. I left it. This was just another plains biome, and I was gonna go back sometime and explore it, but I don't think there's reason to now. And I think that's where we are. Sorry, I wanted to do a whole series. I just thought this thing was super unlimited, and it probably will someday, and then we'll hit her hard, but. I think I've gone about as far as I can currently. And again, if I had to redesign this base, if I could, and I didn't want to take the time to do it now, obviously, but all these chests would be over here. All these crafting tables would be on this side, so I can access heavy stuff and go right to the crafting instead of walking this short distance. You know, it's not much of a time saver, but yeah, gets the job done. Huh, I guess that's it. Anything to look at here? Troll all the way. Fire arrows seem to be pretty good. I got these in case, but I don't know. I'm kind of sold on the whole fire thing. Heal potions. Never like doing potions in games. It's really necessary in this one. It really is, because if you need them, you need them. I got one stamina, because if you don't get out of trouble... with one stamina, then you ain't gonna get out of trouble. You're in trouble. We're good. Alright. That's it, man. That's it. That's all there is. And I will be back, guarantee you, making videos of this game. Absolutely. When they get some content rolling on it. Alright. Thanks a lot. I'll see you on the next one.